floor with the bolster beneath your legs, beneath your knees, yeah? Nice and comfy, spread. Change the music. Ah, yes, you have it. It's not a, it's okay, close, no? You don't get wet, no? No. So you have the, so use the sound as well, just like the water is washing over, yeah? If you have rain at home and you hear the noise of the rain, you can use also the sound of the rain as a cleanser energy, yeah? So start to connect your body on the floor. And as always, focus on your breathing. When you breathe in, imagine that you're starting to receive a beautiful energy of relaxation, peace, and comfort. Imagine every breath that you are taking, you are receiving that relaxation into your body, into every single part of your body, your muscles, your bones, your joints, your organs, your cells, everything is getting relaxation and peace. And then imagine also in your emotional body, your spiritual body also receiving like a bath of peaceful, soothing energy, calming energy. Remind yourself that you are surrounded by loving, caring energy. Yeah? As always, when you come to this room, feel that energy surround you. And imagine that you get the same energy at home. Yeah? Or you can imagine that you receive the energy from here into your house now. Yes, surrounding you with that loving energy. And then imagine that you start to release your roots as always into the floor, into the planet. Or imagine that the roots are waiting there for you to relax. Just you need to relax, to settle, to surrender. And the roots will engage with you. You always have a set of roots. Wherever you are, wherever you go, imagine that you have roots there waiting, your own set of roots waiting for you just to take a couple of breaths and relax, yeah? And imagine the roots engaging and you start to receive already the flow of energy coming from the planet. This time of the day, we want the nice, soft, relaxing energy. But imagine that you receive all the nourishment and all the recharging energy that you need to have it inside you for whenever you need it tomorrow, yeah? And imagine as well as always that the roots are ready there to catch all the tension that you are releasing, all the stress or the stiffness or tightness. And imagine this energy is being recycled, it's being reused to become like a nice and fresh and new, so you can use it back again. Yes, so remember you don't lose your energy. So it's more easy to want to release it, to let it go. Yeah, imagine that all that you are letting it go, you are receiving it back. Yeah, with the same strength, yeah, the same action that you can use that energy. So keeping that in mind, imagine that you set all that process in motion, and now you just let it work for you and you start to focus more now on your physical body. start to feel your physical body, start to feel, bringing movements to your hands, to your feet, yeah, your fingers, your toes. And we can move the head side to side. And we can expand the arms back and soften, yeah? Nice and comfy. Good. Well done. And then we will bend the legs. We put the feet on the ground. You can keep the bolster beneath the legs or just take it out. And check that your back is connecting even more deeply now, that you lengthen the spine. You check that the back of the neck is nice and long. And we bring the knee toward your belly. Yeah? Softening your elbows. Softening your shoulder blades and expanding the back of the neck. Yeah? Softening. Relax. Let go. And let the weight of your leg go deeper and deeper into your belly, toward your belly. And then open the knee to the side. We catch one hand on the knee and the other hand on your foot. Relaxing, yes, softening. And then we stretch the leg up, relaxing your shoulder blades, yeah? And we move the leg side to side. Softening, yeah? Softening the lower back, softening your hips. Keep expanding your shoulder blades on the floor. And then we do like a circles. And then the opposite direction. Good. And then we move the foot in circles. And flexing and stretching. Good, and then relax. And we bring the other knee toward your belly and soften. Relaxing, yeah. Relax your elbows, relax your shoulder blades. And then we open the knee. Open hip, yeah. Try to keep relaxing the lower back. Feel the space between your hips, yeah. Your spine, your head. And then we stretch that leg up and move the leg side to side. And then we move the leg in circles. And then the foot in circles. Good. And then we put the foot over the knee and we bring the legs in this position. Relaxing side to side, relaxing shoulder blades and elbows. Try to expand your spine and your back. And then we roll in circles as well in this position. Yeah? Softening. Oh, and then we change, we go with the other leg. And then again in circles. And then we both legs, side to side. Try to soften, try to feel the shoulder blades and the space between the shoulder blades, yeah, like the middle of the back there. And then we roll toward one side and we turn around and we go to all fours. So have your bolster or your pillow. Yeah. Susan, you can have the roller in front of you. We put the hands nice and open, yeah? And shoulders away, we move the hips in circles. Yeah? So breathing forward, opening the chest when you go forward. Yeah? Sending your shoulders back. Breathing forward, breathe out back. And then the opposite direction. And then on the center, breathing an open arching, shoulders away, breathing deeply. And then rounding, squeezing a little bit the lower belly, relax the shoulders away, relax your neck. So breathing open, expanding. And then rounding. So try to do it slowly and feeling your body as you move, trying to be as much present in the movement as you can. And then we curl the toes, spread the back of the toes, yeah, moving the toes, and opening, expanding again, and then squeeze and round. And then again, expanding. And squeeze. And one more time. And squeeze. Good. And we open the knees. And we go to child pose, relaxing back, softening, letting go completely. Shoulders away, relax. Surrender completely to the floor. And in that touch to the floor, imagine that your roots are starting to act more deeply, to take the tension, to take the stiffness, to take the stress. And then we move the hands to one side. And then we move the hands to the other side. And then coming back to the center. And we will put the elbows on the floor, not with the pointy part, yeah, the flesh above the elbow. And we'll put the hands or in prayer position or above your head or above your neck. And we soften the chest toward the floor, softening the shoulder blades as well, as much as you can. And then relax. We will move the bolster. Keep the position, put the hands over the bolster and keep relaxing your chest and your solar plexus and your shoulder blades, yeah? Spread. And then relax. And we will go to all fours. And now we will relax the shoulder blade on the opposite direction. So we put the shoulder, we put the head, and we can put the hand on the floor or also on the bolster if you prefer. And soften it, relax. Let go your chest, your head. And we change, we go with the other arm. Good. And then slowly coming back, yeah, all fours again, and relax a little bit the shoulders away and move the shoulders and the chest softly. Imagine that we stretch the front and we stretch the back of the shoulders. Yes, so imagine in this movement, it's like we are putting the shoulder blades and the shoulders in a nice place. Yeah, like in a balanced way. And then we go to the other side. And then we will stretch one leg back, shoulders away, expand softly, and then round. Breathing out. And round. One more time. And then we change, we go with the other leg. Expanding. And open. Oh, well done. And then from there, we will go slowly with one leg forward and we walk all the way up. Nice and easy. Try to spread your feet and expand. Yeah. Good. Relaxing your shoulders. Taking your time. Yes. So soften back. Relax. Check that your knees are soft, that you are not tense in your legs. Yeah? Open. And one more time. And then the opposite direction. From back and forward. Try to do it big but soft. Yeah? So you really feel the shoulder blades and the shoulders. One more time. And then we do the opposite, yes? So we go one, going back, sending the shoulder blades down and the shoulders down, and then the opposite. Try to do it really slow so you can feel the shoulders and the shoulder blades. Yeah? One more time. And then back. Yeah? Now, press with your feet and press like with your hands. Imagine that you are touching the floor or the roots and you are using that support to expand the solar plexus, lifting the chest without hanging. Yeah? So this is lengthening and you lifting until the solar plexus, helping like with hands, yeah, pressing and then relax and open your arms. Without changing the shoulders, yeah? Good. And spread. Softening. Keep the knees a little bit soft. Good. Well done. Very nice. And then expand. Relax, release. And then to the other side. And then one more time, more. Now, imagine the palms trying to touch the ceiling, but without tensing, yes? So using the feet, spread, lifting the solar plexus, lifting the hands without tensing or without lifting the shoulders. Expand, yeah? And then bring the fingers and spread the back of your body without tensing either, yeah? Lengthen. So open chest, solar plexus, hands, expanding up. And then spread. Go. And relax, yeah? Soften. Expand the arms. Now to the side again, imagine that pushing with the palms, but without tensing, yeah? Try to spread far away. You can even feel again that sensation, that tingly thing, yeah? Spread, push, expand, and then relax, and we soften. Relax now. Nice and comfy with the knees soft. Yes. So check that you are not tensing the knees, because if not, you put tension. Relax, relax. Good. Soften. Good. Well done. And go a little bit higher now. Soften. Really gently. Good. Well done. Very nice. Now we open chest. Yeah. Stay there. Expanding. Now bring the hips out. We go with the chest and the solar plexus. We go to forward bend, like with the belly first toward your thighs, yeah? Whether you touch or not, you go as much closer as you can. And then once you feel that you are like connected with the legs, you relax the rest of your body. And relax your neck, relax your arms, relax your head. And again, you can stay still or you can move in the same way that we did before, a little bit side to side, but really gentle and soft. Relax. Well done. And then we will put the hands on the floor. We will go. So I will give you my back so it's more easy to follow, okay? So we will put, try to do it with the same leg so it's more easy. We did a couple of times. Yeah? So we put the legs in this position. Yeah? Now check that you are not too close, open. Could be comfortable, could be not comfortable at all, okay? So grounding in this leg, spread, pushing like with your hips here, relax again the shoulders back, and nice and comfy with the belly a little bit in, we will rotate toward this side, with your belly and with your chest nice and open. And we will open chest and we will try to look with your head toward the left shoulder. Yeah, very nice. Now, not too forcing. Yeah, well done. And try to relax the shoulders away from your ears. Yeah? Keep going. Good. Expanding. So, nice breath, expanding, open your body there without forcing. Okay. And then coming back to the front. Good. So ground your this hand, but checking you are not tensing the shoulder. And we will go one more time. Imagine that you start the stretch from the toes. So you stretch the leg, the groin, the belly, chest, your head, your neck, but not in a forcing way. Yeah? Really gentle and soft. But big, soft and big. And then relax. And we will go with the hands toward the front leg. We can put it on the floor or we can put the elbow. Depending on how you feel. And we lean over the leg where it's possible. Like a little bit of pigeon pose, but the side, on the side. Yeah? So soft, whether it's the hands or the elbows, don't force it, okay? Wherever you arrive, relax and expand. And then slowly coming back, we put the hands back, shoulders away and rotated back, And we spread. No forcing. And relax, yeah? We put the other leg, change, taking your time, check whatever is more or less comfortable. When you put this hand, check that the shoulder is back, yeah? Belly a little bit in, and you start to rotate softly, taking your time, expanding, no forcing, okay? So wherever is possible, yeah? Go shoulders away, chest open, very nice. Bueno. Breathe in, open, without forcing, expand your chest and your solar plexus. And then coming back really gentle. And this time imagine that we lengthen like from the toes, yeah? Like you bring an energy of expansion from the toes to the crown of your head, like a cleansing energy. So open, rotate, expand, shoulders away. And soften here, and we will go toward the front leg, wherever is comfortable, okay? So we can be with the hands or with the elbows, depending how you feel, yeah? So softening, taking your time. And then coming back, and we put the hands behind, wherever is comfortable. Doesn't need to be perfect on the center, yeah, wherever is okay for you, and spread. Don't force it there. Open solar plexus and chest, and try to relax the shoulders. And then relax, release, go. And now we will go to all fours just for a moment. And we will soften the hips, yeah? With a little bit of circle. Go. Well done. So whenever you feel ready here, we will put the bolster or the pillow in front to do, sorry, I talk pillow because one of the girls doesn't have the bolster. So we put the knees, yeah, and we go to child pose with the support, yeah, of the bolster, belly and chest. Now, if it's possible, check when you put your chest, yeah, try to, if it's possible, yeah, try to spread a little bit of space between your boobs. Sorry, Ise. So imagine that you want to put the chest bone really on the bolster. Yeah, like you want to separate a little bit your boobs so you feel the chest bone on the bolster if it's possible. Yeah, check if it's possible. That's to open, to stretch the pectorals, but also to work on the heart center, yeah? And then relax your shoulder blades. Relax your shoulders, your elbows. Relax your cheek on the bolster and surrender deeply. Remind yourself of that loving energy that we have around. And if you like, you can imagine here, recreating your cocoon, yeah, that shape around you with that pink light, yeah, the loving energy around you. So you can imagine strengthening the cocoon if you normally have the idea of the cocoon around you, or creating now, like a protection around you, a filtering energy. And imagine that you are inside that nice cocoon and you relax, you surrender, you release tension, stress, worries, anything that could be bothering you. Really letting it go. Using each breath out to let go more deep. And if you feel that you need to release a lot, that you have a lot of things going on, you can imagine from above a really powerful violet light that is coming from above and is passing through the cocoon and is passing through yourself, through your body. And with that violet light, you are transforming and releasing more easily the things that you need to let go. Yes, so imagine the violet light helping you to release and transform that you want to release in a more soft energy, so you can release it more easily and you can transform it more easily. And then slowly, slowly, we will go to bring the other cheek on the bolster. Nice and gentle, taking your time. Keep surrendering. And then slowly, slowly, put the hands on the floor. And we will expand slowly up, taking your time. Yeah? Really slowly, really slowly. Good. Now, you can keep the bolster in this way, or you can add, you check it. You can have a block close by in case you need it. So what we will do is, we will put the legs on one side, yeah, so you are facing me, right? But you have the hips touching the bolster, okay? Any side, because after we will rotate, okay? So what we will do is we will try to rotate toward the bolster. And again, we will try to put the front of the body. So it's a spinal twist supported. So we put the belly, we put the chest. Now, if you feel that the head is too, you put the block or another pillow or another, yeah? So you check. And the head could be or on the same side of the knees or the opposite direction, depending how you feel with your back, yeah? Okay, yeah. Now, could be comfortable, could be not comfortable, okay? So you take your time, try to rotate as much as you can, not in a forcing way, and then allow your body to relax there. Go, very nice. So try to face with your chest as much as you can. Yeah? Go, very nice. Yeah. So, eccole. Now, Noelia trata, estira un poquito más el cuerpo y aplástalo toward the balls. Ah, there we are. Yeah. So try to be really nice and open on the bolster or on the pillow, not too squeezy. Yeah. Now without forcing, and surrender again. Try to relax your shoulders. Very nice. Very keep relaxing. Here we are combining the power of the twist to release the tension and the stress that we carry on the spine, plus the support of the bolster. So imagine that you are receiving the support and the energy from the planet. And as you release the tension and the stress with the twist, you are feeling all that space, yeah, the space on the spine with new fresh energy, with all the qualities that you need. Yeah? And then slowly, slowly, we will go with the hands on the floor, lifting from the twist. Now we will go to the other side. So the best way is just turn around and put the other hip closer to the bolster. Yeah? The knees could be together or separate. Rotate first, try to face the bolster as much as you can, and then slowly you can put the one cheek or the other cheek, depending how you feel. So let your body guide you there. Now, again, could be comfortable, could be not comfortable. Okay, so trying to find a way. The more comfortable way is you can manage to put the whole of your chest on the bolster, yeah? And check if you need extra blocks, that's okay, yeah? Or extra cushions. Try to soften. Check that you are expanding. And then really slowly grounding your hands, we expand back. Yeah. So if you don't have the block, you put the block on the top now. Yeah. And then we just simply turn around again. So put some, elevate a little bit the bolster on the front. Yeah? And we turn around again. And this time we will lying down on the bolster or on the pillow. Yeah. Close. And then here you decide, you can have the legs crossed or the legs open with your blocks beneath your thighs or the legs expanding or bending. Yeah. So nice and comfy with the lower back touching the bolster or the pillow, the hips on the floor. And spread your arms and soften there. Yeah. Take a moment. Oh, spread your spine here, bringing the back of the neck to the bolster, to the pillow, and relax. Open your chest and surrender. Now again, visualize just for a moment like a reminder of that beautiful cocoon around you, the pink light surrounding you. The support of the bolster representing the support of the planet beneath you through the roots. And then again, if you need an extra boost, imagine a violet light from all above the cocoon, bathing your cocoon and trespassing it and entering into yourself, into your body with a beautiful cleansing action. So you are being cleansed, you are being released from all the stress and tension, and you are surrounded still by the pink light, yeah? Filling all those spaces with that loving, caring energy. As you relax completely to the bolster and as you feel your chest is expanding, imagine your heart center opening as well. And you receive that pink light, that loving energy more deeply, like a beam now of full energy into your heart. Imagine the light entering into your heart, trespassing with all that power, your heart with this loving energy. And imagine that pink light that is entering through your heart now is expanding through the whole of your body, through the whole of yourself. To have more this idea, more present, this idea of being filled with the pink light. Start to bring your awareness back to your physical body, If you have the legs open or crossing, you can start to lengthen it. You can start to bring movements to your hands. And then maybe take a really soft stretch. Gentle, yeah? And then we will bend the legs and we roll toward one side, bending your knees. We stop for a moment then. And then slowly, slowly, we will go toward a sitting position. Good. So we will take the bolster now out, yeah, in any direction, okay? We will lie down on your back and we can have the two blocks, and we will go to this position. So pillows, yeah? So you go to lying down with your feet, if it's possible, together or crossing, and we put, if we need, the blocks beneath your thighs. So take the position first or crossing the legs, even just for a moment, yeah? If you, at any point, you can lengthen the legs, but stay a little bit, yeah? With the legs crossing or the legs feet together. And before we relax in that position, yeah, check that you bring the belly a little bit in to feel the lower back on the floor, and then expand the back of the neck, yeah, really lengthen the spine, spread your shoulder blades, and then relax your arms, nice and comfy. So check that your legs are as much comfortable as you can be. And if at any point it's too much, just stretch it, yeah? But try to keep as much as you can the connection with the lower back, yeah, spread it. And then just simply relax and surrender to the floor. Let go in the position, yeah? Let go of your knees, your thighs. And then slowly, slowly, we can start to close your legs. You can stretch it first and then bending. Try to bring the belly a little bit in and relax the lower back on the floor. And then bring your knees to your belly and roll here, side to side, softening, relaxing.